random comment I made about chicken from last week's Sweet Tooth Thursday episode for apple pie cookies.
And since you have leftovers, throw it in chicken or something.
Well, I figured since I said it, I should probably come up with a recipe. This slightly sweet and mostly savory dish is perfect for those of us who hate to clean. Why? Because it's made in one pan.
Chef Steph.
Oh!
First, dice up half of a yellow onion. If you have a food chopper, you can use that. Dice or chop one apple. Just don't make the pieces too small. Like that. To a pan that you have a lid for, heat up 1 teaspoon of coconut oil.
If you only have olive oil in your house right now, that's okay, you can use that too. But I would highly recommend checking out coconut oil. Coconut oil has so many health benefits, including lowering cholesterol, lowering the amount of abdominal fat, it helps build resistance to viruses and bacteria that cause illness, and it also positively affects your hormones to help maintain thyroid and blood sugar levels.
Even my dogs love it. Add the onion and saute for a minute. Add in your apples. Add a pinch of sea salt. Mix and leave this to simmer while we go cut the chicken. Cut 1 pound of chicken into small pieces. By now your mixture should smell nice and sweet. So to cook the chicken, we're gonna transfer this to a bowl. Add another 1/2 teaspoon of coconut oil and add the chicken. Season with 1 teaspoon of salt and pepper and 1 teaspoon of fresh rosemary. Stir and cook on medium heat until the chicken is just barely pink. Add back in your apples and onions, 1 cup of organic whole grain rice, and 2 cups of water. Stir together and bring to a boil. Once boiling, give it a final stir and reduce the heat to low. Cover and cook until all of the water has been absorbed. And it's done! My rice took about 30 minutes because I used brown rice, but if you use regular white rice, it'll take about 20. Garnish with a sprig of rosemary and some lemon juice.
This is a deliciously easy, people-pleaser, one-pan meal. Share a comment below if you have other ideas for savory apple recipes. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, because I'm gonna show you even more delicious fall recipes. Have a great week, and as always, keep it classy.
That's easy.
No, turn it up.